Hey kids, it's Lindsey, and the title of today's video is called What Not to Do When You Hire a Marketing Consultant. All right, so it's time to buckle up and get ready for a good old-fashioned marketing rant. Now, recently, this has come full circle for me with one of my clients, which is why I decided to create this YouTube video here. Let me paint a picture for you. Last year, I had an extremely talented woman coach reach out to me. She had many, many talents. She helped females feel empowered and move ahead. And she was a very, very successful coach. Problem was, she was doing all one-on-one coaching work. And honestly, she could really only do about 3 days worth of that kind of work before she got tired and really hit her income limit. She reached out to me, Lindsey Anderson, the number one expert in helping coaches build and monetize their online business, and it seems like a match made in heaven. Well, after we strategized and after we worked through how she wanted to grow her coaching business, which, by the way, this is something really important to note. There's 500 ways to grow, okay, to grow your coaching business. And when I work with clients, I really try to understand their lifestyle and how they want to grow and what they find passion in, whether it be like webinars or lives, those kind of things. And we try to come up with a strategy to grow their coaching business based on their lifestyle and what they like to do. That was also a mini rant within a rant. So I'm going to get back to my real story here, which is she came to me. We came up with a strategy and we were ready to go. Now, here's the other thing. When you're ready to build your online coaching business and you're trying to figure out the strategy, maybe you want to do a 5-day challenge. They're very popular. They're very potent, but it's not like you can put together a 5-day challenge to sell into a high ticket coaching program. And like the first time out of the gate, you're making $500,000. It just doesn't work that way. Okay. I am a marketer. I am not a magician. And while I am a highly skilled marketer and I've helped many coaches in different niches achieve some amazing levels of success, I don't know what's going to work for your audience. I don't know what they're going to respond to. And so some of that is going to take a little bit of testing. So when one-on-one clients come to work with me through the BAM agency, we always tell them, hey, if you really are serious about growing your online coaching business, you're going to want to, you know, invest in some paid ads. And for her, it was a right fit to do a launch. But I always said, listen, you will probably have to launch 3, 4, 5 times in order to hit the sweet spot. Now, I'm not saying that you're not going to close, you know, several clients on those 3, 4, and 5th launch before you really hit that golden egg of a launch, okay? And that golden egg of a formula of your audience and your offer and your pitch. But what I am saying is that this marketing thing is you have to be open and available for testing. So we always lay the groundwork and expectations with our customers. Quite frankly, my job sucks when I don't set expectations with clients and then they go to launch and it's almost like in the back of my head, I'm like, oh my gosh, this isn't going to happen. And I didn't tell her, right? I always set expectations because that is really important for me and my business that I know I can sleep at night because I'm telling clients like it is. And not only that, that's why they hired me in the first place, so that they could understand expectations and what they needed to do in order to achieve success. Lots of mini rants within a major rant today. I know. Let me get back on track. Well, long story short, she launched. She closed 5 or 6 people, okay? Definitely didn't meet her expectations. I thought it was freaking fantastic that on her first launch, the first time she's ever really trying this digital marketing thing, that she closed that many clients. I was high-fiving myself, okay? She even broke even on our consulting fees. But then we came back to the table and I was like, okay, that worked. Here are my thoughts on how we can improve it. And we really should start moving ahead. She was okay. And then she wasn't okay. And basically is what happened was, Lindsey, we aren't moving fast enough, okay? Basically, I had these lofty, lofty expectations that I would be off living in the Bahamas by now. And yeah, I just don't know. And so she came back at me, and this is the one thing that you should not do when you hire a marketing consultant. She came back to me and said, I'm switching niches. I can actually help women of all sorts, shapes, and sizes. And I have a particular interest in this niche. So I'm frantically going to release that niche because it actually didn't deliver. And I'm going to go for this niche. So please set up some Facebook ads and set me up a funnel that looks like X, Y, and Z and go. And suddenly I had turned from a consultant to more of a, okay, you tell me what you want to do and I will just sit here and do it, even though it goes against every fiber of my being on what you should do, those successful steps you need to take in order to grow your coaching business. So I'll be frank. I sat with that for a couple of days. And then I was like, I'm not going to enjoy this work. She won't be successful if I just continually take her money and I just do what she's saying. And she was a pretty skilled marketer on her own. Okay. And I wrote her an email and I fired her. I was like, I don't think we're going to make a good match. I basically told her in a very, very nice way, what I'm telling you is that I don't think she was going to be successful. Well, or maybe she would be successful, but my confidence level was low because again, guess what? I'm a marketer, not a magician. So if I could tell the future, if I could know what headlines, if I could know how to reach into your customer's heart and pull it out and sell it something, I would. All right. I would say all those words, but I don't. I'm very skilled, but I just don't have that. That just doesn't exist. So recently, just 2 weeks ago, she reached back out. Okay. And it's been several months. And she basically reached out and was like, okay, Lindsey, basically I valued your opinion. You got me to a certain spot and I do want to resume work. I am ready to proceed with the strategy that you told me about. And so we are going to again engage in some work and I'm looking forward to it because honestly, closing that many clients on your first launch, there's so much promise there and I'm very excited for her. So what are you going to do, right? What are you going to do when you hire a marketing consultant? I know this business is your baby, okay? Mm-hmm. I know that you love your logo and your colors and your branding and your voice and your program names and all the things. I know because I also am a creative and everything that I do also comes from my soul. So I get it that when you hire a high-priced marketing consultant like myself, it hurts. It's like, I'm punching you in the gut when I tell you I don't like your logo, or maybe you need to reconsider your program name. But here's the deal. If you hire a high-priced marketing consultant, my advice would be is to get your money's worth and actually listen and hear and understand what they're trying to say to you. All right, kids, I'll see you on the next video.